Hi, this is Home Group 1 and here is a discussion our visual map. Starting with bilinear transformation, which is often used to convert a transfer function HS of an LTI filter in continuous time domain, usually called an analog filter, into a transfer function HZ in discrete time domain known as the digital filter. Designing a filter based on the windowing method is done by truncating the ideal filter, which is an IIR filter with an infinite length, into an FIR filter. The process is done in the time domain, and later the DTFT is used to analyze the filter characteristics.
Convolution technique usually used for combining two signals to form the dot signal. Convolution has relationship with Z transform, where the domain of the signal from the equation may be transformed back to back between each method to obtain difference equation. Another method that closely linked with convolution theorem is sampling method, where convolution usually use time domain sampling method to work. In the other hand, DTFT mainly used to analyze the spectral response in windowing. Also, both of these two methods, convolution and DTFT, are also interchangeable. Explain it by this formula.
So, sampling methods convert analog signal to discrete signal by measuring the value of signal at certain interval in time. Sampling is commonly used in convolution theorem. The discrete signal output from sampling method can then be used to do Z transform, which convert it into a complex frequency domain, which also commonly used in convolution, as well as in conversion of an analog filter to digital filter, which is impulse invariant method, where the transfer function of the digital filter is the Z transform of the impulse response of the filter. So that's all for my analysis. Thank you.
Hello, today I'm going to talk about the noises that are present inside an ECG signal. So inside an ECG signal, there are two types of noise that are present, which are additive white Gaussian noise and power line interference. Also in low frequency, it would include baseline wandering. The noises that are contaminated inside an ECG signal is very uncertain and may lead to wrong interpretation. So in order to solve this problem, we are going to implement an IIR Butterworth signal. So the reason that we choose IIR Butterworth signal is because of its monotonic amplitude response, which are present in both passband and stopband. Also, quick roll-off around the cutoff frequency, which improves with increasing order. However, it has considerable overshoot and ringing instead response, which worsens with increasing order, and also the slightly non-linear phase response of the system.
This is the coding that have been developed. The first one, we set sampling time equal to 100, the frequency is to 5, the time duration 5, and then the end, as you can see here. These two is for testing. We are interested in IIR Butterworth. We set the order equal to 5, and then the cutoff frequency, as you can see here, and then we choose Butterworth. So the equation is butter 0 and omega c. We set b and a as the denominator and numerator respectively, and then the frequency z and fv tools is formed to create the dot plot for our design here. And then we are looking here x phase filter. We filter out the signal here, ECG2 data of the heart rate. And then lastly, we are plotted the comparison. We use the subplot. This plot is for the noisy heart rate, and then the last is for filtered heart rate.
So in the figure 1, it's about the filter design. So the filter design we use is IIR Butterworth. So this is our passband, our stopband. Then this is our magneto, and then for the phase. For the cutoff frequency, the omega C is somewhere around 0.3 to 0.5. We cannot guess earlier because of the scale. Going to our figure 2. Okay, this is the visualization tool, FV. So this is in the magnitude response in dot plot. So as I mentioned earlier, this is passband, stopband. So the cutoff frequency omega C is somewhere around 0.3 to 0.35. So going to our next part, the most important part, the comparison between noisy heart rate and filtered heart rate. So this is the ECG signal given to us. So we can see this is very noisy, the amplitude are distorted. Okay, after we apply the IIR Butterworth, so we can see we actually reduce the noise, and then the amplitude are still clear, but we can see some distortion in the heart rate. So as a conclusion, to reduce the noise in a signal, we can use IR, IIR path of a signal.